One thing you may not know about Beethoven is that he loved to go walking in the woods, and it's where he gained many of his inspirations, and he carried with him a little notebook and wrote down little bits and pieces to use in any kind of music that he happened to be writing. Sometimes it wasn't even related to what he was thinking about, but he then used it later on for something like a piano sonata. This pastoral symphony, I think, is a favorite for most audiences. And of course, most of us remember the Disney Fantasia, where this was just so beautifully depicted, in particular this movement. You can just sort of see, you know, fawns and things running around, and just you can hear the babbling brook. This is the scene by the brook. It is just a magnificently beautiful piece of music, and yet it is very hard, would you say? It's much harder than you would imagine, because there are just so many intricacies going throughout the piece. You can never lose sight of the beat, and you certainly can never lose sight of who has the melody, and sometimes there are multiple melodies going on at the same time. So despite its beauty, I think it's actually a very difficult piece to pull off. And you may be wondering what the heck trombones are doing back there, because Beethoven didn't write for trombones, but I couldn't stand to see these poor people left out this great piece of music, so I wrote some trombone parts for them. Apparently that's a theme for the rest of the season, because again, the next concert series, I'm writing more trombone parts and tuba parts for things that didn't exist. This is a beautiful piece of music, and at the very end we have the nightingale and the cuckoo, and there's one other bird. What is it? I can't hear you. Okay, the quail. Right, the quail. I forgot the quail. It's admirably played by members of our woodwind section, so enjoy.
Thank you.
The next piece hardly needs any introduction. In fact, I think if we started playing it and you didn't have a program, you would know what this is. It's been used in everything from Minecraft to a K-pop song. I'm sure it's advertised pretzels, I don't know. But it has a fun story behind it. Peer Gynt is his name. He's kind of a half-wit. He's not a very nice man. But he is engaged briefly to marry the daughter of the troll king. But in order to do that, he has to turn himself into a troll. And so, of course, he backs out a little bit at the end, and they chase him. So that's it. Thank you.